guys, this is your girl Lebu. Thank you for tuning in and welcome to my YouTube channel. So if it's your first time, you're definitely welcome, and those who have been here as well, you are welcome once again. And thank you guys for your support and for your love, for everything. I really appreciate you, and please don't forget to follow me on my socials. Instagram, it's at miss_20_. Please go and follow, and don't forget to subscribe as well. So yeah, welcome guys. It's a get to know me tag, so there's no really, we don't have a topic, it's just get to know me tag. I feel like I owe you guys a lot of explanation, not explanation, but like, you guys deserve to know me. So I feel like ever since I got to YouTube, I've never done get to know me tag, so I just came in and then I went right in without introducing myself. Okay, I did introduce myself, but I didn't do get to know me tag. So I thought, since we are stuck at home quarantining, let me just, you know, do it for you guys, because I love you guys. So the questions, they are 15 in total, and I asked these questions on Instagram. So you guys ask questions on Instagram, and then I got the questions on Instagram, sorry, and then and on WhatsApp as well. So there are 15 in total. The reason why I wrote them down is because I'm using my device to shoot the video. So please bear with me until I get a camera. So yeah, the first question is, who is Lebu? So who's Lebu? Okay, let me just start it this way. My name is Lebu Clorina Tshweni. So I was born in Limpopo. I grew up in Limpopo. I stayed with my parents at my parents' house at Gamolepo, and then I moved to a boarding school from grade 8 to grade 12, and then I moved to Joburg to come and study. So currently I'm based in Joburg. So yeah. And then the second question is, what did you study? Okay. Guys, I studied finance and accounting. So yeah, I studied finance and accounting, so I'm done studying. So because of Corona, guys, so we didn't manage to graduate, as we know, like, the situation. But anyway, I'm done and I'm just happy. So yeah, the third question is, what are you doing for a living? Okay, I get this question a lot, and I know a lot of you guys want to know, what do I do for a living? So guys, I own a boutique, an Instagram boutique, an exotic hair boutique. I sell hair. That's what I do for a living. So, and I have actually I'm an entrepreneur, if I can put it that way. And I recently opened another business. It's Vacation Group. So it's about, like, we provide schools and companies with uniform. So yeah, we've worked with so many schools, different schools, and it has been amazing. The journey has been amazing. So yeah, that's what I do for a living. The fourth question is, do you support and maintain your own life? Yes, I do. Like, guys, on my previous video, when I was explaining how I started my business, I spoke about this. Like, I started my business when I was 18 or 19, I forgot. Yeah, somewhere around that age. And then I started it because I wanted to be independent. So I am financing my own life and supporting and maintaining my own life. Nobody's helping me. So yeah, And then the fifth question, where do you see yourself in business you're pursuing in the next 5 years? Guys, let me tell you, it's a very tricky question because it requires me to tell you guys about my goals. And yeah, so in 5 years, I see myself moving my business in a direction where people can get other services as well, like installations and styling, those type of stuff. But to be honest, I don't think I wanna open a physical store, to be honest. I don't think I wanna keep it online. That's it. I wanna keep it online. The only thing that I can do a physical thing for is my other business, Batavishan Group. I think as time goes by, I will get offices where we can be doing call lines, contacting our clients, and our clients can come to us, you know. So that's exactly what I'm looking forward to in 5 years. So as for my hair business, to be honest, maybe it might change, but I feel like I prefer online. Maybe it might change, you know, goals change. So yeah, let's get to the sixth question. Okay, question number six. What are your inspirations in life and what motivates you? To be honest, guys, what inspires me is seeing young black women getting it out there, like in terms of entrepreneurship, young black women getting it in terms of not being scared to start whatever that they want to do, being successful and living their best lives, and you know, being Abu Mugel. That's what inspires me, to be honest. So, and then what motivates me every day, like when I wake up, I think about all the things that I want to achieve, what I want to change about myself, and then that's what keeps me going every day. Like, I just want to see myself in a different leather, if I can say. Like, every day I need to wake up to look up to something different every single day. So what motivates me again is being independent fully. Like, right now I can't really say, okay, I am independent, but like, I want more. Do you understand? Like, in terms of, okay, I wanna buy my own property, I wanna buy a car of my dreams, you know. Those are the things that motivates me. So yeah. And the seventh question, are you dating? I feel like this one, like, a lot of people are looking forward to. Are you dating? Am I dating? To be honest, I've been single for the longest time, guys. Like, I've been single in, like, I was not kissing anyone, not talking to anyone. I was just single. And to be honest, it happened because I was heartbroken, my previous relationship. So I chose to take a break and breathe and find myself and get to connect with myself and do the things that I like the most. So yeah, I think now I'm ready to mingle. Yeah, I'm single and ready to mingle. Yeah, if it makes sense. So yeah, let's get to the next question. What's your ideal man? What's my type? Okay, physical appearances. Nah, I don't really care much about appearances. He must be kind, he must be loving, he must be ambitious. Like, that one is very important. Like, I can't date someone who's not ambitious, and he must be compatible, because it's very important to me, because I'm a go-getter. Like, I'm always looking forward to do something and go and get it, you know. So if I'm dating someone who doesn't think the same, it's gonna destroy me. So you have to be ambitious, have something going on for yourself. And I like those men that, you know, those men who can put you to your place, into your place. Like, those men who are like, I can't just be, what's the right word? I can't be, whatever. Okay, let's get to the next question. So What are your insecurities? Whew. Okay, it's a very hard one. To be honest, my insecurities, it has to be, I can say that I used to be insecure a lot, but now I'm no longer insecure in most of the stuff. It has to be my appearance, yeah, my body type. To be honest, I struggled a lot, especially in high school, because I don't know how to say this, but growing up around, okay, when you're in boarding school, you grow up around a lot of students your age, you grow up around a lot of people who are older than you. So when you go through that puberty stage where you get to face changes in your body, like your certain parts are getting bigger and everything, so that's when I grew my insecurities. Like, I must say, I've been insecure about my boobs, to be honest. Growing up, looking at other kids having like medium size, like nice small boobs, and then mine are just like, I couldn't get it. And then until I learned to make peace with the fact that that's how God made me, and ever since that time I made peace with. So let's get to the next question. The next question is, do you have friends? To be honest, guys, I don't have like a lot of friends, but I do have friends, and my friends, like, they are my closest friends, people that I can count on. My sisters, basically, they're my friends. I'm not that person anymore. Don't have a lot of friends. So yeah. The next question, what do you spend most of your money on? I spend most of my money on food. I love food. I eat. I love going out on dates. So that's where my money goes. And then the 12th question, what aspects of your life needs tremendous improvement? This one is very important, guys. Let me tell you something. I'm one person, I can't take compliments. I struggle a lot with accepting compliments and taking credit and being true, living my life, like living my true life, if it makes sense. Like, if you were to tell me that, oh my gosh, you're such an inspiration, look at yourself, you started like two businesses, I'll just look at you like, oh, okay. Like, I wouldn't even hype you up, like, because I don't know the fine line. I believe that, my sister once told me that there's a fine line between bragging and being true to what you do. So I don't know, like, I don't know the difference between the two. So I feel like I'll be bragging, saying, yeah, yes, I know, I'm the owner of what. Like, those who knows me, like, I don't even tell you guys about what I do, you know? So it's one of those things, like, I'm struggling, even now I'm still struggling, for me to come out and say that, yes, guys, I'm a CEO of this company, yes, I manage this and that, yes. I struggle. I can't do it because I feel like I'll be bragging. But at the same time, it's not bragging, because other people, like, let's say investors, if investors were to come looking for a place to invest, how are they going to invest if they don't know what I do, you know? So I'm just struggling with that. But yeah, I feel like I need to improve. And as time goes by, I will improve. So the next question is, what is your ideal successful life? My ideal successful life has to be happy, to be honest. Being happy, it's a success to me. Like, when I'm happy, I feel successful. It has to do with family. I believe in family, like my family, to be honest. Like, being married, having kids, a lot of kids. Yeah, a lot of them. But also, it'll depend on my finances, because if I'm where I want to be in life, expect me to be those moms. So yeah, being happy, being financially free, like in every aspect, being financially free, that one is success. And also connecting with God, getting to know God on a next deeper level and knowing yourself, that's a successful life to me. So if I can have those ones, I'm fine. Like, I don't need anything else. So Yeah, what's the next question? What motivated you to start my business? So this question, like, it's very common, and I answered this question on my previous video where I was speaking about how I started my business and challenges and everything. So what motivated me is because I didn't want to be poor. So yeah, let's get to the next question. It's what word upsets you the most? This is a very weird question, to be honest. Like, it was very weird, but broke. That word upset the hell out of me. Like, if a person would just say to me, I'm broke, and I feel like it's you being comfortable with your situation. You can't just be running around and saying that I'm broke. It annoys me. If a man were to say to me, baby, I'm broke. What do you mean you're broke? Say I'm out of funds. Like, you know, don't say I'm broke. No. And also, there's two questions added. Actually, this is I didn't plan it to be this long, but anyway, it happened. It's a long video. We are here, so I'm just gonna be quick on these two. Sorry. Okay, be good now. So I'm gonna be quick on these two. So this one, it's a bit personal. So she's asking me, do you believe that there are people who are meant to give love than they'll ever get in return? It's a very personal question. It's very, yeah. Okay, to be honest, like, my motto or what I believe in is to not expect anything from anyone. Yeah, and choose people in your life in the sense of choose to be with people who you know they'll do the same things that you do to them. Like, let's say you're stuck and then you know that your friend will be able to help you out. Let's say you need something. Like with me, for you to be my friend, I have to test a few things. Can I be myself, first of all? Can I be myself? Are you gonna accept that? Can I be able to say, friend, I don't have money. I'm out of funds for now, so I can't do this and that with you because I'm out of funds. Not broke, guys. So, yeah, if I can't say those things, if I can't be myself, I have to pretend, or I can't even tell you that I'm out of funds, I spend a lot of money on 1-2-3, or I need money to do 1-2-3, blah, blah, like, then we can't do it. We are not friends, man. We can't be friends. So make sure that whatever that you do, you choose people that will choose you. You're with people who want to be with you. That's the motto. Yeah, it's that simple. So the next one is, how many times do you forgive before you finally get to walk away? I don't count. I'm one person, like, you do something to me and then I let it slide. Okay, it's fine. I usually express how I feel. If I don't feel okay, I'll tell you. I don't feel okay about 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I let it slide. You do it again, let it slide. When I walk out of your life, best believe I'm not coming back. So I don't count, but it happens naturally. Like, when my emotional being, myself, my... what do you call those? Like, when I can't take it anymore, like, I'm just like, nah, we're not doing it. So, bye-bye. So, yeah. And then the last question is, you've done so well for yourself. What drives you? I did answer those when I spoke about what motivates me and everything. So, what drives me, what motivates me is seeing young black women getting it and doing the most, being themselves, you know, and paying their own bills. That one, it drives the hell out of me. Like, it's nice, guys, when people pay for your bills as well. It's very nice. But I believe in being independent. Independency for me comes first. Like, I need to be financially free. I need to be able to do things for myself before any other person can come and do it for me. So yeah, thank you guys. The video is too long. I didn't expect it to be this long. Oh my gosh. But anyway, we are here. It's long. And I just want to thank you guys for your patience. I just want to thank you for listening. Thank you for tuning in. Please, guys, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And also, please, guys, let me know what do you like to see more of me, like the content that you guys would like to see. And I'm game. I mean, like, I'm game to bring the content. So yeah. It's the end of the video, and thank you for tuning in. Thank you for the love. Thank you for everything. I love you guys. So yeah, and also, you guys, you're going to expect a more of motivation stuff. I did speak about this on my first video, by the way. And yeah, anyway, thank you guys. Bye.